Hi, everyone. It's Ange and Bethany, and we are back for season 28 and a half. We're back. What we wanted to do was just sort of reconnect with everybody now that we're allowed to be open to 100% capacity again. So excited. Mm-hmm. Took a little hiatus in January and February, but now we're back open. And thankfully, most of the shows we had booked in March are still on the schedule, and yes, we have a packed April, May,
and June.
We've got a ton going on. So we thought what we would do is just do a really quick mini launch to refresh your memory about all the amazing shows that we've got coming up.
And then you'll just run right out and buy your tickets.
Yeah. And before we do that, I just want to acknowledge the fact that we operate on the unceded and unsurrendered ancestral territories of the Passamaquoddy, the Wolastoqwyg, and the Mi'kmaq peoples of this land. And we are so incredibly grateful every day to be able to come into this building and work and play and gather and create and connect artists and audiences from all over the world in this incredible space. So Wallowan, thank you.
Well said, Ange.
Thank you. Okay.
Okay. Now
so excited. We never get to do a second launch. We build everything up for that one thing, and now we're getting to do it again. It's a bit exciting, I gotta say.
It's a good little reminder for us too.
It is. So this weekend, which is happening the day after tomorrow, we have an incredible dance company coming from all the way from Kelowna, BC. Ballet Kelowna will be here with their incredible show, Mambo in Other Works. Have a look. Legs.
Oh, it's
so great.
It's so cool.
I love
it's
it when,
really
a,
beautiful.
When a, you know, you take classical ballet and then fuse it with another contemporary form. So this is really beautiful. All the restaurants are open again. So great date night.
And it's three different short pieces.
Yeah, very, very short
pieces. So it's
pieces.
Really, if you're unsure or new to dance, it's a really great way to try it out. It's beautiful. I won't torture your husband who thinks he doesn't like dance until he comes.
Absolutely. Great, great music. And Ballet Kelowna are wonderful. They're actually going to talk about each piece before they do it, give you a little sense of what they were thinking when they choreographed it.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Love it.
Our next is based on one. We have a lot of great partnerships in the city, one of which is with Quality Block Party and Peter Rowan. And he's bringing the Greville Tapes Music Club. So he got six different groups of music, six different bands or musicians together at a cottage. They worked out some music. They're going to come, so it'll be six groups that'll have formed three different song groupings.
This is so Peter Rowan. Like, I love
confusing.
You, Peter. Basically, it's really cool local music, and you got to come.
Absolutely. Sadie, Designosaur, Indigo Poirier, Colleen Coco Collins, Tooth and the Fang, and Marion. So lots of great music. Thank you, Peter.
It's exciting.
Then next we have Red Sky Performance. They are this wonderful Canadian Indigenous dance performing group. They're doing their piece called Trace. It's about Anishinaabe star stories, and it's beautiful. Take a look.
Projection in that piece is just beautiful.
Like they're a really, really well-established Canadian troupe of dancers that do a lot with kids' performance and adult performance.
Absolutely, yeah. They're They've been here numerous times, so we're really happy to have them back.
Next is our March break movie. We do this every year.
Love
it's
it.
A free film. Free. Bring the kids. Grandparents, bring the kids. And we do it at 2 p.m. on the Wednesday in the middle of the March break.
Yep.
So you can have a day uptown, go to the market, hang around, grab a bite, and then come to the film, go hang out with the kids, and have a little bit of fun with Stuart.
I know. And this is, we just want to say thank you. We have a couple of donors who actually donate specifically to make this happen. So hats off to them. Yeah. Thank you. You know who you are. Okay. So next. That's March break.
Yep.
We're so next up, we're so pleased to be welcoming back. I'm so excited. Stephen Patterson and the Debaters live on tour. Mm-hmm. So excited. And this year, coming with them, he has the hilarious Kate Davis and Dave Hempstead. Mm-hmm. And for those of you who have ever been to a live Debater show, you do not want to miss this. James Mullinger participated in the last time they were here, and they actually taped it live, and it aired. So tickets go fast, and there's not a lot left. Yep. So I'm telling you right now, go get them, or you're going to miss out on the chance to see this hilarity. And we all need to laugh.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, we need some laughs.
Yeah.
Next up, we have this magical evening with two of my favorite Canadian artists, the beautiful and talented Sarah Sleen and the charming Hoxley Workman.
Yes.
Just beautiful duo. So it's the two of them together doing their own music respectively and then some music together. And I think we've got a sample of one of the songs they do together.
Love lift us up where we belong, where the eagles cry on a mountain high. Love lift us up where we belong, far from the worlds we know, where the clear winds blow.
She's floating away. I love that. And next, we have four-time Juno Award winner, Fred Penner. He's coming back for
his
40th anniversary of the Cat Came Back tour. Now, this actually was supposed to happen in 2020.
Yes.
And has been rescheduled numerous times because of COVID. But what we've decided is the last 2 years of COVID don't count.
No, it's not the 42nd anniversary.
It's not the 42nd anniversary. It's still the 40th anniversary. And I think everybody at home can do the same thing. Let's forget the last 2 years and take it off your birthday.
Yeah.
That makes me under 45.
Can we take all the weight away that we all gained?
Yes, I love that. Yeah, totally. Done.
Let's hear Fred sing.
Continue with it. The cat came back the very next day. The cat came back. They thought he was a goner, but the cat came back. He just couldn't stay away. Give me a nice meow, would you go?
Meow.
When was the last time you meowed for somebody?
I'd meow for you.
And just a shout out to our staff member who loves Fred.
Oh, right.
She's very excited. Now, next. Angela went to Edinburgh Fringe Festival, the Fringe Festival in the world, about 400 years ago.
I think it was that long.
And we were all very jealous, and she saw some amazing shows. One of which was this. It's called Knot. It's a very intimate circus. Circus across the world is changing.
Yes.
It's incredible, and there's so many cool offerings. We're actually going to take a look at Knot.
When marimba rhythms start to play, dance with me. Make me sway.
It's funny too, isn't it?
It's funny. There's a beautiful story that weaves into all of the incredible physicality of the show.
Yeah.
I mean, it's exhausting to
watch
them.
The theater people everyone's talking about this in our nerdy theater world. So it's wonderful. We get really excited when we see something new and interesting. And
absolutely.
It's really worth coming.
It is so worth coming.
Yep. And next, we are happy to welcome back our very own Maritime Traditional Sound, Evans and Doherty. I jokingly said this at the launch that nothing, COVID's changed everything except these guys. And you know, it sounds sarcastic. I'm actually
it's
awesome
it's
Maritime
so
music.
True.
And it's coming back. We're looking forward to having them back.
It's been a while, long overdue.
They're going to roll home from Nova Scotia.
Stupid joke. Did it.
Okay, next is Rain Hamilton String Trio. Rain's this really fabulous Canadian singer. They do chamber music, and they also, it's quite funny and interactive, and they do a lot of chatting in their shows. And they also have ASL interpretation, which we're very excited to be presenting for the first time. And we have also got Rain going in here for a school performance as well.
Which is really great.
Yeah, yeah. I think we have a...
Born one day breathing, gifted these feet that walk the earth. Tread stepping lightly, the earth as our body and our lover. And I've never seen a greener screen.
Beautiful. And Rain's one of those artists who I've had the pleasure of watching over the last decade. Oh, gosh. I'm saying decade. It might not be that long. It's just, you know, I've been here for so long. That's what it feels like. So I remember when she emerged on the scene and her first showcase versus where she is now. And it's really awesome to watch Canadian artists sort of grow and expand. So I'm really happy that we're bringing her in. So I get to talk about circus again.
You do.
Because again, Bromance is a show that I saw in Edinburgh again. And Edinburgh Fringe is like nothing you can, I can't even tell you what it is, you know, what it's like. But it has a huge circus component.
Right.
So there are yurts in every park. you would not believe, I had to go up, you know, all like hundreds of stairs up to this little attic space. And that's where we saw this perform. But circus has evolved from only being able to be seen in large stadiums, you know, like TD Center or the Sony Center, et cetera, to being able to do circus wherever.
Yeah.
It becomes less about the apparatus and more about what the body can do.
That's cool.
And Barely Methodical Troupe and Bromance is a perfect example
England,
of that.
They?
They're from the UK. I don't want to say specifically from England.
I'm
a couple
sure.
of them might be from other places in Europe. It's a lovely story, and it just focuses, and I say story because I find that what circus is doing now, it's incorporating theater and it's incorporating comedy and it's incorporating great music to tell a story. And this is all about all of the different kinds of male relationships there are, where handshakes turn into handstands and backslaps into backflips, and just explores the complexities of male relationships, which I really think is beautiful. And they are uber talented. I went with colleagues and then I went again.
And they're kind of cute too.
I went again alone.
And the music's really great.
The music is great.
I've always been a faithful man. So you came along. I've always been a grateful man. I've always been a faithful man.
I know. I remember the show, and I'm thinking like back to all the circuses that I've seen, and this is one of the ones where you basically hold your breath the whole time because you're just waiting for someone to break their neck. So worth the exhilarating thrill, though.
That's entertainment.
Okay, next up, another one of my favorites, the enchanting Ben Kaplan is coming back. Ben was one of those Atlantic Canadian artists who we were actually able to bring during COVID, and we just thought, no, we need to bring him back when we're open to full capacity because everybody needs to be able to see him. So his voice, I could listen to him forever. I could just crawl right in there and nest. He's charming. He's wonderful. And we're just so fortunate that he's from here. So come see him.
Yeah,
it's
if you
amazing.
Missed him last time, get him.
When I wrote you that letter, you'd already made up your mind. All my words were written in vain.
There are just some artists who embody the music that they write. He's one of those artists. It's astonishing. Okay, and next up, this next one, Bethany and I saw Matt Johnson. 850 years ago in Vancouver. And we have been trying ever since to get him here. We finally got him booked, and then COVID. Mm-hmm. So we've rebooked this show numerous times.
Yeah.
And again, he was scheduled to be here in early March. And we thought, it's going to be fine. Because all projections were looking like we're going to be open, going to be fine. And then Matt called, and there was one small issue that came up. So
his water tank, his escape water tank, which he ships here,
was stuck in Chicago. We're not going to mention any names about why.
For a particular, because there was a roadblock.
On a truck in Chicago, and he couldn't get it here in time.
No.
We're not blaming anybody.
No.
But
we had to reschedule yet again to April.
To April.
So Matt's coming, because he thought about coming without his tank, and we were like,
feel like that's not
I
a thing.
I think we need the tank.
So here's the thing. Matt, a great illusionist, another awesome show for the entire family.
Yeah.
Moms, dads, grandparents, aunts, uncles, I feel like you've been stuck in your house with kids for a long time.
He's really charming.
Really charming. And, you know, we've really done what we can to make tickets affordable. So check it out online. Check this video out, though. So fun.
Talk about the world's best. We're looking at it.
He's kind of a big thing.
He's kind of like, I mean, if you can't believe RuPaul and Simon Cowell, who can you believe? I mean, come on.
Totally right. Totally
so
right.
Excited he's coming.
Okay, next. Classic Albums Live Woo-hoo! Is back. And they're going to bring us one of the favorites from St. John, Led Zeppelin 2. That's Home of Whole Lot of Love. In case you forgot, which you wouldn't have. Because we're St. John. And I say that with absolute total pride.
Absolutely.
Now, in the next, and following on the classic rock theme, we have Miles Goodwin Trio coming. Miles is, of course, the former frontman of Vapor Warren.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to come and do his full repertoire, tell some stories, play some tunes.
Play some tunes.
Good night.
Yes. It'll be lovely.
Yes. I don't think we have a clip of this, do we?
No.
Okay, sorry. Next, oh my gosh. Halifax Music lends us the wonderful Renee Smith. Renee was here with Matt Anderson. She and her backup singers were his backup singers.
Yep.
For the Christmas show. Renee is amazing. She's bringing her whole band. It's going to be a really fun night. Another one of those shows that we fell in love with Renee like 4 years ago, and we've been trying ever since.
Oh, God, yeah.
Together. So we're so excited that she is going to be here.
And has become one of the most influential female artists in Atlantic Canada.
Oh my gosh.
You know, with Erin Costello and, you know, she's brilliant.
She's very active in her community, and she's really smart and funny, and she's the band's of boot.
Yeah, we're just thrilled. She's coming. Yeah. Finally.
Yep.
okay.
What do you got?
Finally, we get to bring, you know, the powerhouse in a little package.
Yeah.
My girl, Iris.
So Jesus, just the other day, wearing funny sandals and a little goatee, dress that he had just died. All in all, he was looking pretty slick.
Now, Iris was here in the fall as part of our Music from the Edges series, which was a coast-to-coast series we participated in that was also a streaming.
With
Janet Call. And she brought the house down.
And we had her on our podcast.
Yeah, we did. We did a podcast with her. What's
the name of that thing?
Meet Me in the Spot Booth.
And you're the me that we're meeting in the spot booth.
Yes.
Check it out.
Oh my gosh, what a great chat we had. She was hilarious.
Yeah.
Lives in PEI and just, you know, I could sit and listen to her
all night long.
I adore her. Yeah. Next up, we have Brent Mason is coming back with the 12th annual Bob Dylan Bash. We're so happy that this has moved to Imperial Theater.
Yes.
It just keeps growing and growing every year and showcases some incredible St. John and New Brunswick talent.
I told you this the other day. My nephew is named Kevin Dylan after Dylan.
Aww.
So St. John is a pretty big Dylan fan.
I think we've got some pretty big Dylan fans. This is a great, great night. And again, another awesome way to support local artists as they get back up on their feet after the last 2 years that we know.
So support local.
Last 2 years they don't have. And then we're so honored to be bringing this next artist. He is just, he's a legend.
Yeah.
Beverly Glenn Copeland just had such an influential career and is one of those artists who's making this interesting comeback
at 70,
later in life. You know, just sort of a trailblazer.
Yeah.
Has this incredible voice and
hooked up with this band. This group
right,
of young
right,
musicians,
right. Indigo Rising. Yeah. So just incredible musicianship, just, you know, like really heartfelt lyrics. If you haven't friended Chroma New Brunswick on Facebook, go do that. They've just posted this amazing biography on Beverly Glenn Copeland, who is living here in New Brunswick now.
Yeah.
Relocated here. So, and we're so happy to have him.
Yeah.
Have a listen.
Welcome the spring, the summer rain. Softly turn to sing again. Welcome the bud, the summer blooming flower.
Beautiful. Feels like he just sings joy.
Yeah, yeah. Now, here's another show. It's been a while.
Mm-hmm.
Canada's Ballet Organ is our favorite storybook ballet. And they have Green Gables, the ballet. Let's take a look. This is the classic storybook ballet. I love it. I don't know what little dancers wouldn't want to be.
I know. Beautiful, beautiful tale, right?
Yeah.
And it's not often that you get to see a story ballet have that many sort of sets and props involved in what they're doing. So
it really
will paint a beautiful picture.
Once again, it was such a big deal when Ballet Organ got the rights. And we've been waiting and waiting and waiting, and so it's coming.
Well, it was originally scheduled for April 2020, right?
Yeah.
So it was one of the very first shows that got pushed and then pushed and then pushed. And here we are.
All right. And now, as our very own local diva, Hilary Ladd, she's shedding her indie music roots and jumping in headlong into like a one-woman show called Breast Milk and Tears. It's funny. She's vulnerable. It's a poignant story. It's great music. It's everything you could imagine. And Hilary is larger than life.
Love it.
And
this was, Hilary was actually one of our incubator artists.
Yeah.
And did a residency with us last year. So we're so happy that she's premiering this show on our stage. And that
it's really
we were
fun.
A part of making it all happen.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Great.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to do retro films.
Yes, you
before
are.
You jump.
Get on it.
I mentioned our retro film series, and Stuart Little was one of them I mentioned earlier, but the rest of our films, Grease, one of the best. Grease is coming, Mad Max 2, An Affair to Remember, Blade Runner, and American Graffiti.
It's a great,
yeah,
it's great series. Our retro film committee does a great job.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
You know, those retro films in. The other exciting thing we've done this year is we connected with the TIFF St. John Film Circuit. And so all of the TIFF films are happening here at Imperial. We're just thrilled. Like, it's been an incredible series of shows.
Yeah.
And I'm happy to announce that the next two TIFF films coming up are The Worst Person in the World,
which is a Norwegian romantic comedy.
And Flea, which is actually an animated.
Beautiful. Really beautiful animated film.
Yeah, yeah. And that's I think it's one of the things that I love about TIFF the most is that the film catalog is so diverse.
Oh my, we're very lucky.
Yeah.
I'm so excited that we're involved.
So pleased to be involved. And here's just a reminder that for every ticket we sell, $1 gets donated back to a scholarship fund that is awarded annually for a New Brunswick student to be able to attend film school. So again, you know, supporting the film industry in New Brunswick, which is really important. So we're so excited about that.
And we have other dates in the future, but we don't necessarily have the films secured yet.
Right.
But we'll let you know.
Yeah. So as things progress, when we do our launch in June, which we're prepping for, what we will do is we will announce all of the TIFF film dates for the following season. So the dates will be secured and we'll announce the films as we're able to get the rights for them.
And we're TIFF Tuesdays.
TIFF Tuesdays. That's what, that's what we thought would be.
Because we like alliteration.
Really great.
Big fans.
Says the marketer.
I'm the alliteration fan.
Okay. That's where we are. So that's Imperial Theatre's presenting season from now until May. Yeah. That being said, please go visit Imperial Theatre. Imperial Theatre's website, www.imperialtheatre.ca. There are a ton of
other
fantastic shows that are touring through. Because we had to close for most of January and February, a lot of the shows that were booked then have pushed into the spring. So, you know, we've just announced, you know, Cat and Nat are coming. Rick Mercer is coming. Yep. St. John Theatre Company has Driving Miss Daisy in March, Annie in May. You don't want to miss those.
There's Symphony, lots.
Yes.
Lots
Symphony
on the
New
website.
Brunswick is coming back. And there are lots of other great tribute bands and other artists who are coming, like the Bahamas, et cetera.
Yep.
So check our website. It is all up to date. All of the dates are listed there. And
it has our COVID protocols.
Right.
If you're curious about what's current, because we all know things are changing dramatically all the time. But check out the protocols. They're always on our website, up to date.
And you can always call box office. Beth and Matt are here and happy to answer any questions you have, help you find your seats. And I guess the last thing we're going to say is we're so happy to be open again. And it has been a scary 2 years. And I know that the thought of coming back together in a gathering space like this is a bit nerve wracking. But I think we're getting to the other side.
Yeah.
And I can tell you that the live shows that we have had have definitely helped heal all of our spirits.
Yeah.
And so we encourage you to invest in live entertainment as a little bit of medicine to help heal all the trauma and isolation we've felt over the last 2 years.
Yeah.
We're there.
We can't wait to see you back.
See you soon.